Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Sir?
We have a comment, Carter.
Good evening, Mr. Tony Garcia, and I'm here to request that I get the land cleared.
I'm sorry, say your name.
Tony Garcia. I was on it last year as a stakeholder, and I'm going to make the time to attend meetings and, you know, public media out as I can. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Garcia.
Madam Chair, I have a question for you. Do we have quorum to continue our meeting? Okay, I'm sorry. What would you like to say?
Yeah, there is. There's seven of us. Four of us.
Go ahead. Good evening, my name is Yoli Garcia. I'm a regular stakeholder here at the LA 32 Nursing Meetings, and I am interested in the Budget and Finance Committee. I also have served in the Budget and Finance Committee in the past, so I do have experience there, and I'm a pretty active member in the community, and I would like to be part of this committee. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Garcia.
We have two other comments from Ms. Garcia. Yoli Garcia, I think they just spoke.
Is that in addition to what you said? Or
no, no, that was
okay. I think that was it. And Jorge Garcia?
Same.
Yeah, there's nothing else.
Okay, there's no more, then we'll move on. I would like to state that I did receive some emails from stakeholders also expressing interest who are not present, are not able to be present tonight, but did send me interest and qualifications. So.
Can you give me a copy of that email?
Okay, we're going to move forward. Starting with the Budget and Finance Committee, for the bylaws is mandatory for the Treasurer to be part of the Budget and Finance Committee, so Michelle's office will be on the committee. Oh, I'd also like to clarify that for right now we'll be appointing three members for each committee. There is a little bit of misclarification in the bylaws as to how many committee members there shall be or must be, but we're going to stick with the portion that states three, that the president shall appoint three committee members. We can always entertain the idea or agendize placing more people on committees if need be. Budget and Finance, Michelle Crisantes, Roxy Malgar. At this time, I'll appoint one stakeholder on that committee. And Yoli Garcia. Again, we may add, as many of you know, we don't want an even number of members on a committee because then there's a chance to have a tie vote and we need tiebreaker votes. So for now, Michelle Crisantes, Roxy Malgar, and Yoli Garcia. Land Use Committee?
The director, the leader to accept the...
The director? No. Okay. Land Use, Angela, Duarte? Jorge Garcia? And I didn't get any other board members that expressed interest in the land use. Is there somebody that didn't respond to my email that's interested in the land use? Okay, we'll put Alan, Alan Prieto. According to our bylaws, there's no limit. On which committee? It is, you know, and to be honest with you, for the Land Use Committee, it is an extremely busy committee, and there's a lot of work on it. It is one of the committees that I would like to appoint at least two more people, but I didn't have any other interest. Okay, yeah, I may be looking at putting two more people on there, and I do have another stakeholder that's interested in the Land Use Committee. Moving forward with the Education Committee.
Hey, can I appoint myself?
You can ask. We asked that anybody come up and state the committee that you'd like to be appointed on. State your interest and reason.
Land use. Do I just...
Yes, please.
My name is Dina Chen Lee, and I'm interested in land use. Do you have any questions?
What makes you an asset to the committee, or whether you're interested in the land use?
Well, we have property here, and I think I want to make sure that, you know, it remains good. And I like the stable that I come through it every day, so I'd like to be on that committee.
Okay.
I'm sorry, can you say community?
Dina, D-E-E-N-A, Chen, C-H-E-N-L-E-E.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Chen Lee. Like I just said, right now I am only appointing three, but however, land use is one that I would like to add some, hopefully on the next agenda. I have you down. I will keep you in my notes, and if I'd also like to email prior to you meeting the meeting, so we can notify you whether or not we will be appointing at that meeting. But again, I do thank you, and land use is one that we definitely want more stakeholders and a bigger committee involved. Education Committee. We're going to vote for each committee after I appoint them. Just for clarification, I am making the appointments. The board does have to ratify each of the committees. After any of the committees, we will go ahead and take a vote for each committee to ratify.
Questions? Well, so are we appointing chairs
today? That's later on the agenda to appoint chairs. Yes. But it's not on this item number. I believe it's maybe next. Yes, it's next. Okay, for the Education Committee, can I ask a question? Nicholas, you're president of the education committee, can you expand on the reason?
Yeah, so one of the reasons I was interested
in being involved with the education committee was, well, one, I'm currently a student at Cal State LA, trying to become a teacher, so I've been involved in teaching at various elementary schools, and so I would like to be able to tether in not just the K-12 schools, but also the higher education institutions located in this area, so that we can pour the resources that these institutions have into the community. That way, we can prepare our children and the high school students to get into college, and that way we can provide them with adequate resources, tools, so that they're always ready to go into college, and that those college students are giving back to the community. Thank you.
Thank you. Adam, can you also
elaborate? The reason I've been involved in the education committee, at this moment in time, I represent the English learners at our school. I am part of the parent advisory committee. I am part of the discipline task force at LA Unified, and I work with families in schools, which is a nonprofit that helps benefit the schools. I am so involved within the Unified District that I need to be in something that we can give back to our children so we can have a better future. As a parent, and as some of us are all, we're all growing older in our lives, and our future are our children. So we need to be working with that future. That main point is getting them the education that they need. Being able to get them to a future where they're going to be able to provide for their families, but not only for their families, but provide for our state, our city, and bring back to our community what we need to have. Thank you.
Sasha?
Because, well, first of all, I'm a student over at Cal State LA. On top of that, I've been involved in an after-school program. It's called ACES. It's for the Alhambra Unified School District. I've been working with them for a little over 4 or 5 months now, and I would really like to implement a similar program here in El Segundo. I think it's really beneficial, and it really promotes education and student success. I would really like to encourage all the students in this community to go on to college. I'm heavily involved in a statewide organization known as CSSA that is a governing board for all 23 Cal States. So I know about the different requirements to get into different Cal States, as well as the different programs that different CSUs offer. So I would really like to emphasize that and let other students know about that and just really get our students involved with our university here at Cal State LA, as well as helping them get into college in the long run. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sasha.
Sorry, I have a question.
Okay, Michelle is also interested, but she did send me her reasoning as to why. Would you like to take that?
Hi, my name is Michelle, and I'm interested in the education committee. I am involved with the LAUSD. I'm a full-time volunteer. I am in the parent advisory committee through the LA Unified District. This committee is a committee that is parents. We sit down and we put together, we work with the budget of the LA Unified District, and we put in our strong recommendation on how they should go about the budget. And also I'm in the Library Task Force Committee through the LA Unified School District, which is a committee that we are trying to put together a budget for the libraries, so there could be more libraries in the schools all around LAUSD. Because some areas do have them, some areas don't. I am also a committee member with the LA Unified District with the special needs, special education needs children. That's also a committee that we do an outreach. We speak, we are the advocacy for the parents who have special needs students. And not only that, I'm very networking friendly with all the elementaries here in the El Segundo area. I have personally spoken or know the principal or the parent center unit. And it's something that is a valuable asset that I have that connection, that reach out with them because they have a familiar person they can work with, and we can reach out and do something interesting for the El Segundo education in our school, not just LAUSD, but public schools, charter schools, and any other schools that are here in El Sereno. So it would be a reach out for all schools, not just LAUSD. Just so you know the backbone that I have from LAUSD. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to make a correction to my land use committee. Is that okay with that? I mean, has it been voted on? Okay. So, okay, for the land use, I'm sorry. It's going to be Angela Duarte, Jorge Garcia, and Cynthia. I'm sorry. You said land use, right? For the education committee. There is a stakeholder. Jorge Garcia. Mr. Garcia, you spoke. Jorge. I said Jorge. Okay, so for the education committee, we'll go ahead and appoint Michelle. Nicholas. And I do prefer there to be a stakeholder, but okay. I'm sorry, there is no requirement. So if she wants to, she can appoint a stakeholder, but there's no requirement. As long as three members. Stakeholders, we have one. Board members, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay. So,
I mean, because there's some ambiguity in the bylaws, we're going to go ahead and stick with three right now. And if clarification is made, then we will go ahead and possibly add some members to committee. Yes.
You consider me for the committee specifically because I'm the South Region representative, and how CLA like to listen to the district. It's in the South Region, and it's played a huge role with what's going on in University Hills, and I think that if we can expand, if I've already met with the university president, try to expand on outreach efforts as far as the two other high schools here, as well as the elementary students.
There's two options. We could appoint all five, we could appoint the three, and then have another member be a chair, because currently the chair cannot vote, and so the chair can act as a facilitator, and the three members can still discuss and vote without there being a tie.
But the chair can't break the vote of a tie.
Sure, but if we have a few extra, if we have a surplus of members that want to be on it, then it would make sense for me to, or it would make sense to my.
As long as the number is odd, but if the vote is even, the chair will break up.
Yes.
Right, but that's not the point we're debating. I think what we're going by right now is what's in the bylaw of three.
Well, it doesn't say that it can only be three. And so it's ambiguous, and so that gives us the option to appoint more than
three. Right, it is ambiguous, and that's why right now we're appointing three, and then we can add once the clarification on the bylaws is made. Or the bylaws are rewritten.
So just really quickly, on page 13, it says, with the exception of the executive committee, the president shall appoint three committee members. For each committee to be ratified by the
right.
Last board had to like cut the number of committee members for each committee. So just to be safe.
Okay? So again, please understand that I would like a couple of the committees expanded. If that's what the bylaw committee, if they do make that change, then I would hope that we could add some, or maybe they could, you know, give the committees the determination to be able to determine that. But we're not there yet, so as of today, just to get the committees going, we're only appointing three. So again, for education, did I name three already?
Yes, you did.
Okay. Does somebody want to step not participate in education? Who's already been named? I said Michelle, Alan, and Nicholas. And only because I had to, there were other committees that you were interested in.
I am the South Region Director, and because Cal State LA is located in that area, it has over 23,000 students. I do think that it's quite important. But if not, I did express to Marvin that I did have several interests, and I was willing to be flexible, but education is one of the committees that I am very interested in, just because of what I believe is my responsibilities.
Madam President, a point of interest. I think the candidate that just spoke is the ideal candidate for that particular committee. It would be a no-brainer to get her in.
I think all of them have their strong points. And not appointing one is not taking any of their strong points away from them or making a statement that they're not a strong candidate. I think everybody is. Again, for the sake of what we need to do right now to get the committees going, I'm going to remain with my three choices. Business and economics, there's not going to be any discussion because I got those via email, and Sasha, Capricia, and business and economics. Sasha, Capricia, and actually, Jessica.
Jessica
Gordon? Jessica. Oh. Yeah, I have no stakeholders that I know. Nobody emailed me and there were no stakeholders present. Oh, are you interested? Business and
economics?
I'm sorry, I
didn't
express interest. I know you didn't. I just thought maybe you were
more
qualified.
Okay,
go ahead.
So Jenny
Burrow,
are you interested in also business and economics?
Okay, and because Jessica just stated that she's not interested in business and economics, we'll go ahead and name Sasha, Capricia, and Jenny Guerra. Okay. For the outreach committee, now
everybody. I have a point of interest. Again, I apologize for interrupting. Some of these appointments that you're making now that are stakeholders, since we have several vacancies in our board, down the road, the people, when you start filling those, some of those people, there are stakeholders now, become board members, and since you were already going to have the required board members in whatever committee that they're in, will that disqualify them then? Because then they will no longer be a stakeholder, they will be a board member. Should they be appointed to our board?
I mean, I can't predict who's going to be appointed to the board, so it's not going to hinder my decisions on appointing committee members, but absolutely they would have to.
That's not what I addressed.
No, they would have to step down.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, lastly, the outreach committee. Again, I'm going to say that I didn't get emails from everybody.
Madam President, I'd like to express interest in the outreach committee.
I actually have you on there, young man.
Oh, you did? All right, great.
You didn't tell me what committees you wanted to be in, but you told me what you're good at, so.
Oh, okay, great. Thank you. Appreciate it.
So, Gamaliel? outreach. And what I was going to say is a few of the others were repeats that I had already received. So anybody, right now is your time, board members? Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Like I said, they were repeats, but. Yes.
I'm interested.
Okay. Okay, Gamaliel? I've already appointed you. Yeah, okay.
I was wondering, did you go over public safety at all?
No.
Is there going to be one?
No, not on this agenda, I believe.
Next meeting.
Oh, the committee, yeah, no, we're only doing five right now. Next meeting will appoint the next five committees.
I'll make sure I come.
Right, we're short on time and we and that's what's on the agenda, so. Sasha? Jessica? We need to take a vote for each of the committees.
Can I get a motion to ratify the budget and finance committee?
I would like to make a motion to ratify the budget and finance committee on this.
All those in favor, raise your hand and say aye.
You don't have to say aye to raise your hand. You have to stand up and comment.
All those against?
Aye.
All those against? Abstained?
Office.
14-0.
14-0. I would like to make a motion to ratify the. I'd like to make a motion to ratify the appointments to the ladies.
Is that you?
I'm sorry, you have public comments on it?
Yeah, after the motion comes public comment.
Oh, I apologize.
Okay.
You know, this is what I'm talking about. You got them representative. When we were doing the bylaws, one of the reasons I got fired is I wanted to stop the imperial president. Because when you take a look at Robert's Rule of Order, Toastmasters International, every one of you is equal. The president is probably the least equal one. You know why? It's supposed to remain neutral. Neutral. And by giving her or him this kind of power, you guys are giving away a power that you should get back. And one of the reasons I say that is you should be, as a board, making the decision who should be on these committees, not solely the president. And that's why one of the reasons I got fired by the last president, and the president wanted to take over the bylaws to make sure that that power remained with the president. Take it away. It's your power. And it's been taken away by previous administrations and done is doing nothing to do it right. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pacheco. I didn't write the bylaws.
I know. Done it.
I just have to go by bylaws. Okay.
I would like to make a motion to ratify the appointments made for the Land Use Committee.
Second the motion. Okay, so all those in favor, say aye. Or raise your hand, it's easier.
Aye.
Any against? Abstentions? All right, 13-0-0. Agreed.
If you're asking us to say aye, you also have to ask us to say no.
Mr. Chavez, please. Anybody, any public comment on that?
No public comment. Any motion?
I would like to make a motion to ratify the appointment of the Education Committee, Bruce Raisio.
All those in favor, raise your hand and say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, say no. Raise your hand and say no. Abstentions? 13-0-0. You guys abstain?
We were doing the education committee.
Yes? Who's the abstention?
I had a question. So, is my understanding that we appointed,
My understanding that we appointed six individuals to the bylaws committee, or?
Well, we'll get to that, but do you abstain for the, to vote for ratifying education committee?
No, I'm okay.
So 12 yeses and one abstention.
Business and economics, any public comment?
I would like to make a motion to ratify the appointment made for the business and economics committee.
John, do I have a second?
John. All those in favor, say aye and raise your hand.
Aye.
All those against, say no and raise your hand. Abstentions? Okay, 13-0.
Yeah.
There is no public comment.